Michael A. Taylor will join us for a couple of seconds now. Baseball America said the best athlete in the entire Nats organization. How about that as a compliment?
That's a very nice compliment.
When you look at what you've done as far as coming out of Westminster School down at Fort Lauderdale, has it been the kind of a rise to success that you envisioned when you were 17, 18 years old? Or is this quicker than you thought?
No, I was that naive kid coming out of the draft that thought I would, you know, be a year or two and be in the big leagues. But spent some good time on the bus in the minor leagues.
You come back from AAA Syracuse a couple of days ago. Now you're back with a big club. And when you look at center field, the guy that whose place you took because he was on the disabled list, Denard Span, has he been a nice role model for you, taught you a lot of things?
He has. He's a great ball player. He's a great guy. You know, I watch the way he goes about his business and practice and spring training and things like that, and his work ethic is amazing. You know, and that's something that I've tried to model in my game also.
When you look at you defensively, you've got such great speed out there. You can run down almost any ball hit your way. What's the toughest ball off the bat that you have to gauge so you don't do three steps in and 100 steps back?
Yeah, luckily it doesn't happen too often.
Yeah.
Bryce actually hit one the other day. You know those balls that are like 110 off the bat directly at you, and you can't tell if they're going to rise or stay down. That's a tough read, and you don't have much time to make a decision. You don't want to go in and get burned, and you don't want it to land, you know, 3 feet in front of you.
And with the speed you have, when you get on base, what's the one thing in your mind you're looking at from that pitcher in the mound? Making sure if you're going to steal a base, you get a good jump not to get picked off first base.
Yeah, just trying to be comfortable out there. Naturally, guys are going to hold the ball, pick over. You know, so as long as I'm out there, I get a good, solid lead and, you know, feel good out there and comfortable in my jump. Hopefully, you know, it works out when I get to second base.
And how about when you're in that batter's box? What's the toughest pitch you've had to encounter and overcome and succeed with time and time again? Fastball, breaking ball, slider?
I think coming from high school, slider is a pitch that you don't see too often just because it's a tougher pitch to throw for younger guys. You'll see fastball, curveball, changeup. So early on, and I'm still working on it, you know, getting used to that slider and laying off the ones out of the zone.
When you're playing down in the minor leagues, as you played a couple of years, of course, the folks at Potomac remember you well. Guys are a little bit erratic with their pitches. You never know where it's going to go. A lot of guys aren't digging in, and now you get up here and they can finesse you all night long.
Yeah, and even when they fall behind, guys will they'll still come at you with their off-speed stuff because they have confidence in their control.
Gauge, for me, you're feeling in that clubhouse now as this ball club is now starting to get on a roll again, playing the kind of baseball that people expected them to play.
I definitely think so. Our pitching has been great. You know, guys are starting to swing it, and you know, pretty soon things are going to really get rolling here.
Michael, thanks for your time, buddy. Always great to visit with you.
Thank
you. Also, you're getting a degree in the offseason from Troy, huh?
Yeah, I've been taking classes online, you know, trying to be proactive in that so I don't have a ton of hours when I'm done. So hopefully that works out.
Best of luck to you.
Thank you.
You bet.